please don't tell me you're gonna yell at me or anything, okay? I've had a really tough day.
Really? Well, it's not over yet.
We have got to find a way out of here. Because besides having to get our...
You lied to me. Not once, not even twice, but over and over again.
Cooper, it wasn't so much a lie as a subtle massage of the truth.
Give me a break, okay? Massage, give me a break. You told me you quit the FBI and you were working undercover the whole time. That's a lie. That would be called a lie.
All right. From here on out, no
Your
more lying, okay?
Grudge against Danny Santos, your sick quest for justice. I've had it with you. I have had it. You know, you can't trust me with the truth. Fine, you can be on your way. Mm. What, is this funny?
No.
Is that a smile?
No, it's just encouragement. It's not so much that I lied. That would have been okay. It's that I lied to you, right? And I'm touched. It gives me hope for the two of us.
There is no hope for us. None.
Well, what are you getting so worked up over me for?
Because I am afraid that you are a pathological liar. Really. I mean, you are a law enforcement chameleon. You've been so many colors, I don't even know what side you're on anymore. What side are you
on? I'm on my side. Mine. Care to join me?
No, because I can't trust you.
Oh, like you've ever had a partner that you can trust. What, your big doofus brother, Frank, or what was his name, Dave? Dave, is that his name?
David.
These guys treat women cops like they're can-use, and you know it.
Can-use?
Yeah, can you get me a file? Can you get me a donut? Can you make my coffee black?
I get it, and you are so off base about that.
I am the best partner you have ever had.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, no, I have. Who was there for you? Who's taught you a few things about surveillance in the van back in the day? Who was there for you when you gave birth to your baby? Who was it?
Who wanted you?
I was there, yeah, but I was there, right? I was there, and what does that tell you?
You stole the father's cell phone.
I didn't
your own
steal his phone. Are you kidding me? I answered the phone by accident. That's all I did. And I was going to give him a message, but the guy was acting like a jerk. A jerk. And I didn't know that you were in a prison. What, is he still saying stuff about that? Is he still complaining about it? I will meet him in the parking lot at 3 o'clock in the afternoon,
I don't want
okay?
that. I don't want that. I don't want that. And I don't want glib, okay? And I don't want, you know, here today, gone tomorrow. I don't want that. I want somebody who will be here for me always.
Well.
And who will tell me the truth always.
Okay.
And who is kind. And you know what? You fail in all counts.
Then you should be with Rick.
Rick is a great guy.
Go with it.
Who does not lie, I might add. And if Rick would marry me tomorrow and we could raise that child together, I'd do it in a second.
Well, then seal the deal. Go on, beat it. Go be with the guy. Go on, what's stopping you?
Nothing anymore.
This portion of...
All right, May, thanks.
There was a time when I was afraid to settle down with Rick, but that time is over.
Oh, yeah? What got you ready for him? Valium, tranquilizers, heavy drinking, ouzo? Was that it?
No. Just watching you. Watching you thrash around, doing your thing. Destroying your only friendship, destroying your career. Hell, you're snitches. Don't do that. When I am trying to talk to you, okay? I hate that. Blowing smoke in my face. It's disgusting. And you know, compared to you, Rick's straight-laced life is a sane, inspired choice.
Well, then, you know what? Get ready for a long, boring year. I picture you both in 40 years on a porch with your little fold-out chairs as the big 18-wheelers go by going, hey, waste of life. I give it a year. A year.
Well, thank you for reading my future. Do you want to try reading my mind? You give up? I'm thinking it's time for you to disappear.
You know, it doesn't take a psychic to see that you and Rick are not a perfect match.
Who is my perfect match? You? This?
Something. I am quitting.
What, smoking?
No, I'm quitting the bureau.
Oh!
You don't believe me? You don't believe me? Call my supervisor. She'll tell
you.
Oh, yeah,
I'm sure she'll be quick to tell me the truth.
Uh huh. But sometimes you're really just not that fair to me. Or that kind. Okay, I have been honest with you on the really big things. I have.
Then you name two. You name two.
I live my life the best way that I know how. And I travel around, and sometimes you meet a special person. And you take a special person with you, the memory of that person. And I think that you're just gonna be one of those special memories.
What does that mean? Does it mean you're leaving Springfield?
Thanks.
Good riddance. Leave town. See if I care. But it's just so typical. You know, it's what men do when the going gets tough. They leave.
What's that mean?
It means you've gotten your value system from watching too many late-night westerns. But believe me, when you ride out of town, there's not going to be a kid chasing alongside your horse yelling, "Come back, Gus, come back."
Shane. I like that movie. That was Gary Cooper, right? So you don't think I should leave?
No, I think it's a great idea. There's not going to be one person in this whole town who's sad to see you leave. How does that make you feel?
Not a single one.
There is nothing here to stop you from leaving.
Managed to ruin my last smoke.
Ask me if I care.
Do you care? Obviously, you don't. I'll see you later, kiddo.
Harley, what are you doing here?
I am so happy to see you.
Kmart is open six.
So I'm confused here. What's going on? I thought you were heading home.
I was, but I just got distracted. Uh-huh. But I'm focused now, and what I'm most focused on. How lucky I am to have such a wonderful man in my life.
Great. What's his name?
You, Rick.
Me?
You.
Oh.
What is so funny?
It's nothing. It's just all of a sudden my stock has gone way up tonight. It's just, I don't know, it must be the clone or something.
I'm trying to tell you something important here and you're making jokes.
I'm sorry. I didn't know you were serious.
Yeah.
Anybody have a match?
I thought you were gone.
Well, do you remember the movie?
What movie?
Oh, remember? Shane, the guy comes back.
So you were here before?
Well, yeah, if I'm back, probably means I was here before, Rick.
But yeah. He is leaving town for good.
Well, that's good news.
I feel like I need to say something. Here. I haven't been honest with you. I've been a coward. I haven't been upfront about my feelings for him.
I see.
Yeah.
Well, go ahead.
You know, I mean, sometimes he annoys me like he annoys everybody else in town. But there are some times when he's made me laugh, and I just haven't been entirely honest with you about what I feel for Gus Ituro.
What do you mean? I'm not trying to convince myself.
I know what Rick's situation.
I'm sorry for, you know, blurting that out like that. I think I've been trying to figure out how I feel.
Well, please don't let me stop you.
Right. So yeah, he, you know, he annoys me and sometimes he makes me laugh. But am I interested in him? No. That was a crazy infatuation, is what that was. But now everything has worked out the way it's supposed to because he is leaving town, and you and I can get on with starting our wonderful life together.
Harley, it sounds to me like you're not sure what you want.
No, that's not true. That's not true. I mean, maybe there was a time when I felt something or thought I wanted something, but that is gone, okay? You know what this was? It was like a rebound thing. It was self-destruction, a self-destructive urge. But it's gone now. And what I'm looking forward to now is getting on with what I want, which is a sane and a healthy, wonderful life for my kids with you.
Harley, are you being honest with me? Are you sure? Good. Well, have a nice life, Vitoro. Oh, and be sure to send us a postcard from whatever rat hole that you drift into.
I'm not leaving. Who said I'm leaving? Not me.
What are you talking about? You told me that you were leaving. Is that another one of your lies?
No, I never said I was leaving. I was asking for a reason to stay, and actually you just gave me a really, really big one. You just told me how you felt about me in front of him, and you know what? That tells me I should stick around. I should just lay my hand and see how it goes. So I'll be seeing you around a lot. Later, Cooper.